Welcome, everyone. Welcome to the first showcase event of Dancing Classrooms here at Pike Lake. This is exciting. My name is Amber Reichstadt, and I am co-president of Heart of Dance. What's Heart of Dance? What is that? That is a Minnesota nonprofit that just formed 3 years ago to bring the benefits of ballroom dance to 5th and 8th graders in the schools. And it was only this year that we came up to Duluth, and we are so glad we did. And we are thrilled to be in all of the schools here in the Proctor School District and to be here at Pike Lake. And you know what? That's because we have terrific partners, and you're going to hear from Mr. Hughes just shortly. But let me tell you first about what Heart of Dance and Dancing Classrooms is. Heart of Dance is the nonprofit, but we brought in a program from New York that's really global, and it's called Dancing Classrooms. Has anybody ever seen the movie Mad Hot Ballroom? Anybody here seen the movie? Oh yeah, Mr. Hughes has, all right. Well, that is the story of Dancing Classrooms. Dancing Classrooms is a global program. What you see here today is the same program that is taught in Israel, Switzerland, New York, and around the country in 30 sites, only 30 sites. Minnesota is the 30th site in the world, and that's why we're so excited to be not only in the Twin Cities and Rochester, but of course in Duluth. We started here in the fall with 2 classrooms, and so this fall we've got 5, and we're hoping to grow in Duluth as well. We hope you'll like it. That's why we want you to fill out your surveys, because your surveys are important. If you like it, that will help us to grow in the room and the Proctor area. So thank you so very much. Now, we have some folks to introduce real quickly here. Heart of Dance has an education liaison. She is the person who works with our teaching artists and the school, make sure everything's doing well. That is Andrea Cuzzo. Give her a big round of applause. Some of you might be dancers. Well, she's a professional dancer, but she's loving this, and she was the champion to bring this whole program up to the Northland. You're also going to meet our teaching artist. He'll introduce himself in a moment. So with that, I'm just simply going to turn it over to Mr. Hughes. I'm going to ask all of you to fill out your survey, how important that is. If you want to find out more information about Heart of Dance, we have some brochures on your way out that you can do, you can look at, and we also have our website, which is www.heartofdancemn.org. So with that, Mr. Hughes, I just want to say that we pick our partners too. And it's important to us to have partners that really are engaged and really work with us from the very beginning. We could not have been more thrilled to partner with you and Pike Lake and Ms. Teresa, the teacher, who have all been terrific. And so we thank you for this partnership. We're really looking forward to these fabulous integrators. So here's the reason why we're here.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And I do, you know, very much appreciate that partnership and your willingness to be patient with us and find a schedule that works for all of our buildings. So thank you for your effort. And certainly thank you, parents, for allowing your kids to participate. This has been an amazing experience. I have to tell you, I had lofty expectations, but this far exceeded anything that I could have ever expected. And so that's in part through your students and their willingness to engage. And certainly Mr. John, you're going to see him in action, has been an outstanding teacher for our kids. I know we're here to experience the dance, so I won't take any more time. I would like to invite in Mr. John and our amazing fifth grade students from Ms. Shanoff's class. Please put your hands together for them. Thank you.
Thank you all. It's very exciting to be here. My class that I've been working with for 20 sessions is the greatest class I could have asked for. to all the parents, guardians, friends, and family, you've got wonderful, wonderful kids. And give them all a round of applause. They have been behaving like real, true ladies and gentlemen, beyond my wildest expectations. So without further ado, I'm going to welcome them onto the dance floor, and let's give them a round of applause. Will be Luke and Autumn.
Buenos Aires is the capital of Argentina. The tango has no clearly defined origin because people from all over the world celebrate. Thank you.
I would just like to say that they learned this entire dance in 10 weeks. In fact, all of these dances they learned in 10 weeks, meeting twice a week. Isn't that amazing? Well, something that's actually very cool is we know, if you notice, the second time we did this, they did it without any coaching from me. I didn't have to say the pattern to them. Now, that didn't have to happen today. They could have very well had the coaching the entire time, but they didn't need it. We've got a whole classroom full of ballerinas. And now, I would like to welcome our next speakers for the rumba. We have Brayden and Eowyn. I would like to welcome Caleb and Summer and Bryn and Mason. We are going to jump into the circle. Normally, when there are students, ladies and gentlemen, without partners, we give them what are called ghost partners. And that can be anyone that they imagine it to be, whether it's Optimus Prime or Shakira. two prime examples. But since we have some openings, I'm going to jump in the circle so we can all dance together. Thank you.
Merengue. The merengue is a national dance of the Dominican Republic. The origins of the dance are surrounded by folklore. One of the legends of that a great hero was wounded in the leg during one of the many revolutions of the Dominican Republic. A party of villagers welcomed him home with a victory celebration, and out of sympathy, everyone dancing felt obliged to limp and drag one foot. It is an easy dance to learn and essentially a fun dream.
Dancing classrooms is not just a dance class. We're not just learning the moves. We are actually learning very important principles called respect, elegance, and teamwork. When we treat ourselves and others with respect, elegance, and teamwork, we are presenting ourselves to the world in a way that sets us apart from the rest, makes us a little something extra. So our curriculum connections are how they connect what they've learned dancing to their other studies. I have to brag about this class one more time. I know I've done that a lot. I was supposed to come in on our 10th session and say, all right, Ms. Shanoff, we're gonna do a curriculum connection, and here's some ideas that you could do for this project. And I come in, and they said, hey, Mr. John, look what we did. They did all of this without my asking them to. They did the whole project. So two of the students actually took me into another room to show me these hanging up on the wall, and when I came back, they had all the words. They were holding them up and waving them, tango, rumba. They did basically two projects in one. So once again, give them a hand. I would like to welcome our demonstrators for the merengue. We have Jane and Avery, and Alyssa and Mason.
Five, six, inside circle, nine, five, six, five, three, and five, eight, nine.
your foxtrots.
Thank you.
graders, let's do some swing.
Stop!
for you, but this one's actually a participation process here. We want all of you to join us for a dance you probably know. Everybody stand up. Everybody up. I promise when you hear it, you'll know what's happening. We're going to have everyone in here face the audience in directions so they can all see.
Sure if we wanted to do ballroom dancing, but you made it easy and fun. We always look forward to Tuesday and Thursday dancing with you as our teacher. Thank you. We will always remember you.
Graduating class last year with many valedictorians, and I expect this class to probably do the same sort of amazing work when they transition to the middle school and the high school. So parents, families, community members, thank you for helping us celebrate this culminating event. It's been outstanding, and I look forward to bringing dancing back to Pike Lake as long as you all continue to support me with that. Thank you.
Before we end, I wanted to say two things. One is housekeeping. We'd love your surveys. And you can put it right on the table back there. We'd sure appreciate that on your way out. I've seen a lot of culminating events. I've seen a lot of fifth graders. And I need to tell you, you are doing great. You have been awesome today. Thank you. Program that's yet to come. On May 20th, there is a team match. It's called the Colors of the Rainbow Team Match, when all 15 schools that are participating this semester will go down to St. Paul and be part of a team match with all the other schools, and some of the students from Pike Lake will be there, and you are all invited. If you happen to get down to St. Paul, we'd love to have you there. And I just know that your school will be well represented. So with that, I want to thank all of the parents and family members here. I want to thank Mr. Hughes and Ms. Teresa. Should I say that name again? Shanna. Ms. Shanna. Give her a big round of applause.
Make it the first half, and we can get anyway in. So give us some time, and we'll get a